I just got back from a crazy 48 hours in Los Angeles. The highlight of the trip was spending an afternoon with my celebrity trainer friend, who gave us some of the secrets from training everyone from Justin Timberlake and Jessica Biel to some of the world's foremost CEOs and top performing athletes.
My training philosophy's morphed over time. That has an expiration date, it just does. I really think that for long-term health and fitness, there's things I did in my 20s that I can't turn back the clock on that. Play the tape out, it's coming, and it's just a matter of when. One hill I'll die on. Chelsea Handler's gym is dumbbells to 25 and a bench. JT on the road uses a...
It was a crazy trip. You're gonna love it. Let's go.
Gotta get that large black cold brew for this long flight. Otherwise, I ain't getting shit done. I was looking through my Instagram comments earlier, and I'd posted this picture after my marathon, and I looked like pretty shredded. This woman commented like very earnestly saying, "Great time, do you not train shoulders?" Like she wasn't talking shit. She was literally wondering why my shoulders are so underdeveloped. Oh, have you not trained shoulders for the last 7 years of your life? Is that why your shoulders look like that of a 13-year-old boy?
That was the second time we touched hands today, just now.
I think that was the first time we touched hands.
Nope, on the plane. First.
I didn't notice that one, so it's kind of weird that you recognized it and I didn't. Kind of means that it meant something to you. Elizabeth just sent me this video of Roman at home having zero fun on a Wednesday. So good. The way my baby whooped that thing on me. This is the best bite of food in the world. Good butter on a piece of sourdough with like a good soft scrambled egg. Goated. You got me walking, talking that talk. My friends tell me, baby, don't love me no more. Baby, give me trying for you. I want you to come on in this house, baby. I just can't live it without you. Hear me cry, baby.
What do you want?
What are you asking?
No, I just remember when you were running.
Spit it out.
What?
Spit it out. What do you got? I don't have time for this.
When you were running your marathon and
shut
you were...
Shut the f*** up. Can't you see I'm trying to work?
What do you think like my best...
Dude. I'm literally... I literally just started working. You waited until you just shut the...
So you only travel for a reason. Why are we here in LA? What do you want to get out of this trip?
I normally try to make sure that I have one like anchor meeting if I'm gonna go to a place, and then I'll build out a schedule around that. So the main anchor meeting for coming was spending time with a dear old friend named Ben Bruno, who is a now like world famous celebrity and professional athlete, personal trainer. Trains everyone from like Justin Timberlake and Jessica Biel to a whole bunch of NBA players and NFL guys and everything in between. And he and I are collaborating on a program that's going to be part of my book part of the kind of like the resources and part of the tactics that are included in the physical wealth section of my book. So we're spending some time tomorrow filming all of the kind of tutorials for that, and getting to get some lunch together and catch up, just because I don't see him that often. And then around that, I built out some other meetings. So spending time with a few producers out here, starting to have conversations about potential unscripted television opportunities that may be really interesting in the coming couple of years. So excited to start exploring that and starting to learn about some of these new mediums that I know nothing about.
Given the amount of, you know, sodium that you consume, you know, pre-marathon and the puffiness that comes with that, would you say you're nervous to be on camera tomorrow, or like you're good to go?
Hi, bud. What are you doing? You have a cow? Where is it? Can you show me? Oh, sheep. What else? Chicken? Yeah, buck buck. Thank you. Night night. Here at the office of Omaha Productions, Peyton Manning's production company, co-founded it with a guy named Jamie Horowitz, who's become a new friend. Gonna go meet with Jamie, spend some time together, and go check out this office. Food video. I don't know what that was, but get some of that on there.
That was you.
That Worcestershire. That Worcestershire good.
Spell Worcestershire.
Yeah, I was gonna say, what? Worcester? What did you just say?
No.
Ooh, that olive oil. Oh, that high pour swag.
Well, I am Martin Scorsese filming this one.
What if people like want, what if they're like,
get Sahil off camera, I want Lucas. Who's that good-looking guy who you did the coaching video with?
Who's the guy that looked uncomfortable in his own skin while having his life criticized on camera?
I did look really uncomfortable.
Yes. Yes.
How'd you expect me to be? That was my first time.
It sounded like what you say after having sex for the first time.
What did you expect me to be great at it? It's my first time.
This looks good.
Yeah. Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you. That's great, thanks.
Incredible.
Oh yeah, go for it, thank you. Through the penny at the shore, sank beneath my feet and fell. Through a penny at the shore, sank beneath my feet was all. Too much for the way I wish I could breathe. Too much for the way. Same old. I'm here with my dear friend, Ben Bruno. He is a trainer, strength coach that works with everyone from professional athletes to celebrities, entrepreneurs, and everything in between. All right, so walk me through a simple anaerobic workout that you might do with someone for building VO2 max and for kind of just jacking up your heart rate and getting that training effect.
Well, so it really depends where you are in the process, but where we typically start is super simple. You just hit start, do 7 seconds hard, 23 seconds rest for about 7 or 8. The goal is to not let the RPMs or watts, depending on how you gauge things, drop on each interval. And we'll slowly build up the work interval over time. The thing about this bike is it doesn't sound as hard as it is when you're doing it. So when you, if you were to actually go 30 seconds as hard as you can or 45 seconds as hard as you can, most people in the beginning only have a couple in them. So let's start with 7 seconds on, 23 seconds off for 7 or 8 reps, rounds. And the goal is just to not let the RPMs or the watts go down.
So this is an important point, because usually when you get advice on doing an anaerobic workout, it's always like do a minute, do 2 minutes of work, and then 3-4 minutes of rest. But what Ben's saying is important. You don't actually need that interval to be that long. And oftentimes your performance actually deteriorates a ton from it being that long. So you can start super short.
A lot of cardio workouts that I see for beginners are way, way, way too hard initially. If you actually train people and if you're actually putting in effort, it's going to look super simple on paper, but you definitely want to walk before you run on this type of stuff.
All right, I'll do 1 7-second interval with a...
High handles?
High handles. That'll definitely get your heart rate going. Especially with only 23 seconds of rest.
Remember 7 minutes in heaven?
Yeah.
Is this 7 seconds in heaven? Or 7 seconds in hell?
I mean, by the time you get to like interval 10 on that, you're gassed. I mean, just like the background too on Ben and my relationship. We've known each other since I was 16 years old, which Ben probably has some stories about me that I wouldn't want shared. Certainly knew me at a time that I was very different and much more immature than I would say I am today. But at
in
the
many
time,
ways, I'd say you were cooler.
Maybe, that's true.
I feel like you peaked early, actually.
You know, Ben was like at the pinnacle of a craft, training some of the most elite NHL players in the world at the time, decided he wanted to make this change and really like take this leap of faith, move out to Los Angeles and change what he was focusing on from a training and strength coach perspective. Now, fast forward, that was in 2013. So we're 10 plus years later, and you are, you know, one of the foremost strength coaches of everyone from, you know, Fortune 50 CEOs and entrepreneurs to celebrities whose names you can find all over the world, to some of the biggest athletes that you see playing on Sundays or wherever in their, you know, in the NBA finals. What would you say have been like a couple of the key lessons or insights that you've developed from a physical training perspective that any normal person can pull into their lives that you've learned from these like top performers in their different fields?
One thing that I learned early on, I have a assessment process that I do with clients, and it's just 3 questions. And I just ask your goals, your injury history, and your past training history, because I actually think your profession plays very little into what we're going to do for your general fitness plan, because, you know, your body's your body. And that's the thing about training. Basketball, for example, I train now more basketball players than any other sport. 1 year I trained 3 guys in the All-Star game, and I was like giving myself a pat on the back, and then I realized there's 30 guys in this game. That means there's like 27 different ways that they train, and they're all in the All-Star game. And it kind of made me realize like there's just like more than one path that leads to Rome.
Yeah.
You know, I think a lot of times people think it's like my way or the highway, but I think that when it comes to health and fitness, you just have to find something that works for you. You know, like think about how different you and I are. We're both pretty fit guys, but like if I went on a run with you, I'd have to tap out within like a minute. And some of the lifts I do, you'd have to tap out, and you know, like
I just did.
I think I hate the cold plunge more than anything in the world. Like I try to be a good person in life, because if I'm like, if there's a cold plunge in hell, like I gotta avoid that shit. I gotta find a way to like be, you know, I can't do this. Like it seems like you really like thrive off cold exposure, whereas like I've learned the Wim Hof breathing. I've done all the stuff. I've been coached by, you know, Huberman at his house on how to breathe through the cold plunge, and every time I get in, it just feels like I just like gave myself a panic attack for
no
reason.
Yeah.
And I don't feel any better. I just like it stresses out my system. I'm like, this can't be good for me. And I think you just have to find what works for you.
And how do you think about the kind of whole intensity debate around this stuff? Like, are you seeing
I've changed a lot about
10
that.
Out of 10 every day on this stuff?
Like, no, so I've actually changed a lot about that. And I think that it's kind of my training philosophy's morphed over time. When I first moved to LA, I was in that stage. I was 28, I think. And I was in that stage of just progressive overload at all costs. I got to get my lifts up. I got to build muscle and blah, blah, blah. And that has a expiration date. It just does. It's, you know, it's different for everyone depending on how they're built. But, you know, very rarely will you meet someone in their 50s, 60s, 70s that took a hardcore approach the whole time that feels good. It kind of like, it always reaches an expiration. And, it, you know, that point's different for everyone. And it's funny because I'll look at, you know, there are some outliers. So you'll see a dude that's 45 on social media just lifting like heavy as shit being like, dude, I'm fine. And I'm like, it's coming. Like, you know, like you just like play the tape out. It's coming. And it's just a matter of when. Movement really is medicine in the sense of if you looked at the side effects of exercise, you know, it would be the best medication ever. If you could bottle up exercise, you'd be rich. You know, it's in terms of improved body composition, in terms of mood, in terms of bone density, in terms of, you know, exercise has been shown to help with depression. Like the list goes on and on and on. But at the same time, if you think about any medication, the devil's in the dose. So the right dose heals you, the wrong dose, you know, if you take too much, it kills you. And I think a lot of our type of people think if some's good, more's better. And that's not always the case. You know, like, you know, if I take 2 to 3 to 4 ibuprofen, it make me feel better. If I took the whole bottle, like, I might not wake up. And so I think that a lot of us gym people take a good thing and make it a bad thing by just overdoing it. And, you know, I have a lot of residual knee, hip, and back problems that I think if I was a little bit smarter in my 20s, I wouldn't have that. I really think that for long-term health and fitness, that 7 out of 10 hard consistently is the place to live for just steady improvement and not hurting yourself and staying healthy. And that's sort of like where I would say is the correct dose of the medicine, so to speak, when we talk about exercise being medicine.
I love that characterization. 7 out of 10 hard consistently is the recipe for achieving success in health and fitness, but also I would argue in most areas of life. So like if you can just stay in the, I always talk about staying in the game. It's like when you go 10 out of 10 on anything, you threaten knocking yourself out of the game. Like I just ran this marathon last weekend and I was pushing way too hard in the early miles. And at some point I knew if I keep doing this, I'm just gonna not finish the race. Like I'm gonna take myself out of the game. So let me dial it back so that I can actually get through to the finish.
I give every client this spiel in the beginning. I'm not the hardest trainer, it's by design. If I could get you to your goals without being sore, I'd be happy with that. There's probably gonna be some soreness, but I try to mitigate that as much as possible. And, you know, we're in this for the long haul. So I'd rather you leave today feeling like I'm too easy than too hard. We can always do more, but you can't. Sometimes, like I said, like there's things I did in my 20s that I can't turn back the clock on that, you know? And there's sets I did where I'm like, I feel it every single day in my hip where I'm like, I wish I hadn't done that. And it's okay to do that with my own body. It's not okay to do that to clients. So I slow cook the process a lot more. And
at the end of the day, they're not a professional lifter. Like they're not,
no.
Justin Timberlake is not trying to be the best lifter in the world. He's trying to be the best performer and be able to be a dad and a husband.
No,
and
correct.
Do all these
other
things.
I think that if you do it consistently over time, that's a great example. He's a black belt in the gym.
Right.
So, you know, but he's, you know, you just chip away over time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's an interesting way to think about it. Dude. You've been sleeping this whole flight, now you wake up and shove a fire.
Where are you going?
Dude, I'm such a big fan.
No pictures.
I've been watching you every night for the past like 14 years on all forms of media. Oh, you're tall and articulate. Hey!
I've literally never met someone who sleeps more on a trip with their boss than this guy. That's all for this trip to LA. Hope you guys enjoyed it as much as we did. I gotta go find my family, which means y'all gotta go.
If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to the channel. You're gonna love some of the other videos we're putting out. And as always, until next time, stay curious, friends.